Good morning, everyone. My name is Sudip Chaudhary. I am here to present before you a presentation on tourism in Assam. So let's start our presentation. So, we are going to see what are the sustainable development goals in the tourism sector of Assam. So, at the very onset, I would like to tell you about Assam, what Assam is. So, actually, it's a place of natural beauty. Warm, beautiful people surrounding with tea gardens and all. So this is what Assam is. So as we go through the statistics, so you all can see in the year 2011 there were 43,39,485 domestic visitors, and as compared to foreign visitors they were 16,400. Again in the year 2012, the number of the domestic visitors has considerably been increased to 45,11,407, and but the comparison between the foreigners and the domestic visitors has widened a lot. So similarly, up till 2015, the records what it has been shown here, as you all can see that in the year 2015, 54,91,507 visitors were from domestic, that's from India, and as compared to that, only 24,673 persons were foreigners. Now let us have a look at what we all can do, or what are our visions regarding enhancing the tourism in Assam. So as you all can see, our vision is to make tourism an important tool for socio-economic development of the state. As we all know that Assam is surrounded by a natural beauty. It's a ethnic majority ethnic type of tribes and peoples that are only exclusive to this particular region of Northeast India. So we can make tourism as an important socio-economic development sector for the progress of the of this region, as well as the state and in the broader sense as of India. Now, as I have already told you that since Assam is socio-culturally enriched, so we want to make this environment sustainable. It should not be like that the tourist comes and they destroy our property and all the things are being ruined. It should not be like that. We should look at the long-term sustainable goals. Also, we must promote tourism in Assam so that the people they are coming from outside do not face any problems as such in this state. Also, we need to improve the quality of the tourist products. So, what are our challenges? So, our challenges are we need to aggressively market all these tourism products. Then, there are a lot of inadequate infrastructure, you can say, in response to tourism. Awareness is also less among the people. Skilled manpower, lack of skilled manpower. So, and apart from all that, you know that this northeast part of India has plenty of abundant rainfall. So, it also results in a seasonal-based tourism, which you can't see whole throughout the year as compared to the other tourist sites in India where you can roam about the whole year. That's not possible in Assam due to the climatic conditions out here in the northeastern India. So what should be our strategy? Our strategy should be to engage professional consultant to create new investment sectors here so that the private sectors can also include with the government sectors, and thereby this coalition will bring a fruitful result in the tourism sector of Assam. So also we need to introduce skill development programs. At present, there are various NGOs in Assam. They are providing skill development to our youth. Also, self-employment generation. See, nothing is compared, like everything is, whatever the person do is for bread and butter. So ultimately, at the end of the day, whatever activities you are going to do must result in self-employment. Okay, so these are the estimates of what our goals will be and how to achieve that. I have already discussed with you that how we can achieve this goals, tourism goals. So these are the periods, as you can go through this chart, like this period has already, this 2016-17 to 2018-19 is already been over. So the target was creation of job, like direct, indirect. Direct jobs are where the people are directly being engaged into the tourism sector. And also there are some indirect jobs where people are indirectly engaging in this sector. So it was estimated target that direct jobs will result in 10,000 and indirect 30,000. So in this way, you can go through this whole chart, and up till 2030, these are our goals that are to be achieved. So what are the sources of fund? The sources of funds are from Government of Assam, Government of India, CSR, and private investment. So that's it. Thank you.